All right, we're gonna be doing a defect, and hopefully redeeming that last run's massive mistakes. Go this way, maybe, because then if I don't get the snipe, I at least have fire before the boss. I am locked into it, though. We have a shop. Most likely we can add stuff. It's a later shop than the other one. The route after is okay. You know, we can take this path. If we're really spicy, we could take that path. But most likely this path. Get the second elite. That's reasonable. It also isn't unreasonable to take max health on defect if the snipe seems very unlikely. We got a good potion right from the get-go. That is interesting. Against Hexaghost, I might not mind a consume, to be honest. I mean, none of these are going to help with elites. Well, I mean, that's not true. Consume will help against two of the elites. Maybe I just take a consume. I think I will. I don't love it, but what else was I gonna do there? Gold is good here. Yeah. Barrage with consume. That's the only attack I've been offered so far in this run. Not gonna tilt, not gonna tilt. Just gonna take a cool headed and hope I get an attack. I know I'm guaranteed to get an attack, but that is the attack I'm offered. I guess go for the eyes is technically an attack. Well, Glacier Claw. Potion. Pocket. Could also remove a defend. It's not out of the question. Because we want the claw to be found more often, right? Is it better than getting a potion? I mean, these are all certainly takeable potions. I don't think the vulnerable. I don't think I have enough damage to actually take the potion. I think. What is it, 56? I get one of these potions and a go for the eyes. Then we start opening up things like skim and all for one. I don't really need a go for the eyes as a thing. Like, it's not adding damage to the deck necessarily. And it's just adding damage and mitigation more unlikely, which I already have plenty of with the Glacier and the Consume and the Cool Headed. I can remove some damage mitigation. Because I think I'd rather keep the strikes. I'm quite low on damage. Let's remove a defend. I have a very strong potion. Knob is probably just going to kill me. Oh, fuck. Alright. I guess I'll remove a... another defend. Wow, this is a weird fucking run so far. I think I should be resting. Could upgrade that. I mean, we're most worried about the knob. I don't think any of these upgrades help me against the knob. What does help me is just resting so I can survive another hit. I'm probably okay into the other bosses without an upgrade. So yeah, let's rest for now. And then when knob comes, I probably still just die. Okay, it's not knob. Glacier versus consume. I could consume Zap. Doesn't seem great. If I'm going to use this potion, I should use it now. Got the claw in. Oh, wait. Oh, my God. Oh. Alright, give me this mulligan. Come on, I've had some brain issues lately. You gotta give me this one. You gotta give me this one. How did... Jesus. Is it happening? I mean, a bolt lightning is the smart choice here. Claw. I totally didn't. My brain is off today. Why did I? I don't know. I don't know what's up with my brain. That is not worth my gold. So I think we take this elite on. With claw. Look at this deck. Kunai, ornamental fan, two claws. Claw, claw, law. Unfortunately, won't get the ornamental fan value coming up. I don't know, do I need to do this? I think I do need to do it now. I don't want to get, like, stuff played on the other turns. Did I just play three defends? I played three defends and then Ascender's Bane. Yeah, good use of that potion. Okay, we're not going to reload, though. The other one, it counts. Oh, look, five skills. And turn two. That's what you want to see. I think a Glacier technically could be worth it. Consume, maybe. I think it's just Glacier and nothing else. I think this does nullify the extra strength that they're getting. Yeah, we're not really that close on damage. No, whatever. Is it worth it to defend here? He gains, like, I'm vulnerable, so, like, he gains a lot. I think it is worth it, though. Because I have the dexterity. I can't do the exact math, though. Alright, 31, I can do 16, bringing him down to 15. And then I can do 12. I can kill him with a potion, let's just do that. So it did end up being correct to play that defend, because we saved a little health. Did use both my potions, though. This is maybe worth. Hexaghost? Yeah, let's do it. That's actually an upgrade target now. I could upgrade, or I could bottle the Glacier. Though against Hexaghost and either Laga or whatever their name is, I think a Consume might be better. Not really. I think a Glacier is worth bottling here. Alright. I have no potions, but it's not Knob. Like, I'm pretty good into these other fights. Maybe I'm not that good into sentries, though, huh? I feel like I am. We upgrade the beam cell for now. In preparation. Like, it's not good into sentries, but it is good into the Lagavulin. Jawworm. See, the bottle already paid off here. I technically don't full block. Probably should full block. It's Hexaghost, but... this deck is a strange one. Sweeping Beam? I don't have any AoE. It's also an okay upgrade target. Could be good in Act 2. Could be good to draw claws. Right. This turn is pretty obvious. I think I want to preserve that one versus these. So I could dual cast to save more health here, or I could get damage in. We haven't done much damage. Unfortunately, our claws have been... I could do one claw, I guess. I kind of want to get... You know, I can heal four already and get a kunai proc. I think that's going to be better in the long run. Plus, I get close to killing here, which I need to do, or else my deck is going to be completely consumed. Okay, do that. I don't know that I can afford a consume here. Maybe consume is the call over strike, though. This has to 1 out of 3 to kill that this turn. The only thing is I lose my frickin' thing if I do that. Why don't we draw? Thing is, this doesn't actually... help me this turn. I guess it just helps me draw a card, which hopefully is a dazed. It's not. Alright, we're gonna get 2 zaps in, I guess. Damn, we would have hit him anyway. It's unlikely. I mean, most of the deck was a 4 there is fine. Try to kill that one. Come on. He only had to hit him once. It still could hit him once. There we go. Alright. Wait, that's... Yep, 12. Strawberry, yay. Doesn't really help me with Hexaghost. That'll be a good potion into it, though. This... I don't know about all this. Boot Sequence would be good Act 2. Might be good in this fight, but it's definitely not good for... to, like, eat another one of my opening draws into, Hexaghost. I think we skip. It would have been nice to have drawn our AoE. It's weird. I notice, like, I'll watch the streamers play, and they add one AoE card to their deck. And then they always draw it into this fight. And I never draw it into this fight. I literally never draw it. You know what, though? It's not that... I never upgraded it yet, so it's not that big of a deal. It wouldn't have actually done anything here. But it is just, like, kind of funny. But we could give ourselves a shot to kill this one, I guess. Is that better than random hit? I think it is. Look at that. Okay, I can't complain about luck anymore. Damn it, my claws. So that would do 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. That'd put this in range of that. Yeah, let's just kill it, right? Well, I could put 2 of them in range. Okay, that's better. I don't know why I didn't just start with dual cast. Questionable decisions. Questionable decisions. Claw for the finish. Greedy play. Static Discharge into Hexaghost is probably it. I could upgrade that instead of Sweeping Beam. I don't know that Sweeping Beam is going to beat an upgrade on that into Hexaghost. Yeah, pretty sure into Hexaghost we just do that. I probably... Yep, let's just consume Zap here, actually. I'll play a Glacier on a different turn. And we can do this now. Oops, should have drawn first. Okay, no punish. I'm gonna attack, I think. I don't think dual cast beats it. Eh, it would have been 20 damage. This would have been better earlier. Take the damage. I mean, it's 2 damage, which will get me more lightning. This is probably worth it. I want to take the damage here. I still take damage, so we can dual cast. Actually, think if I let that burn hit me, I would have killed him there. You can full block here. It's fine. Should be able to finish with a single claw, right? Boom. What the hell is this deck? Biased Cog with my consume. Seems wild to skip a Biased Cog. It's also crazy that I don't have a single power yet. Oh, I do have a power. I don't know that I would amplify it. It's probably multicast, right? Is it? Not without a Dark Orb. I mean, I have the it's probably just Biased Cog. I probably am not really playing Consume outside of that fight that I just did. Definitely not Velvet Choker, but I do have now another weird decision. It's like, I don't know that Ruinic Pyramid is that good for my deck. I always want to play the Claws when I see them. Same with the Beam Cell. I guess I do want to hold my Glacier sometimes, and the Biased Cog sometimes. But I could just have the Inserter Consume combo, which is pretty nice. I have, you know, I don't have to make it a full-on meme clon deck, because it isn't really giving me the components to do it, right? But I'm now getting, like, offered a Consume Inserter situation, which is admittedly pretty slow. And my deck is, weird to say it, but with an upgraded Static Discharge and a Biased Cog, it's still pretty slow. I think Inserter is better for this deck. Hopefully this ends up being correct. Seems weird to pass up a Runic Pyramid. But I do kind of think it's correct. Ah, that is a brutal path to get that early shop. And all of these paths pretty much are kind of brutal. I don't think we take on any of these early elites because there's no campfire before. I could hit that campfire, but then I'm only looking at one elite max, and probably it's the green elite, which, I don't know, maybe. But then I don't even get a shop. This map sucks. I guess I could go this way, get a campfire there, then I could get two elites and a shop. That's probably the call, but then there's horrible shop placement. Look at that shit. It's like, I basically am forced to buy this, even if it's a bad shop. Most likely I have to be forced to spend all my gold here. And then I hit that and get nothing. But what else am I going to do on this map? Do I really think I can take on... In either case, it's like, this is like 4 hallways, maybe even 5, into an elite without resting. Keep in mind, my deck is not one that's going to save me much health. I'm definitely taking hits right now with this deck. What about this route? Do I think I can take 3 to maybe 4 to 5 hallways? Elite. And after that... No, I think the far left is the way to go. Still, though, 4 hallways. It's going to be brutal. Maybe we do end up just taking the shop. We'll have to see how dire of a situation we're in. I guess it's just Glacier Discharge. Do I pass up 18 damage here to scale out 2 focus? I think it's a long enough fight that probably, yeah. I do shuffle a thing in, but that is going to help me in the long run here. Definitely playing that, and I guess we play that. It's fine, I only take 2 damage, therefore I get a bunch there. Yeah, this is actually pretty fine. 14. I should take the damage. I think. Hey, do I have to at this point? I'm gonna kill it pretty soon. Let's not take the damage. A lot of ways I gotta kill him there. We get a good turn for the inserter. Another good potion. I might still take the capacitor. Rebound would have synergy with the claw, but I hate to disappoint the people, but I don't think we're going to go in on that. I think a capacitor, even though we have the incinerator, whatever you call it, is very good with the consume, the discharge, the glaciers, everything here that this capacitor works with. We don't always wait for inserter, right? Cool-headed and hope we don't draw any of these 3 cards, basically. So it's 3 out of the 14. It's less than a 25% chance that I draw either of them, right? Is that math correct? Because 3 times 4 would be 12, which would be a 25% chance if it was 12 that I draw one of them. So I think it's fine to do this. Okay, that's fine. We want a glacier here, though. This fight's going to go on long enough that I think we can do this. And we're going to lose enough health that I think it makes sense. I think we want to attack 3 times and defend. Get hit again, and we don't have static discharge, which sucks, but yeah, there's not much else to do this turn. Oh, we didn't take damage, right, because I have bias cog. Okay, well, that's good. We're gonna get quite a lot back here. Just doing static discharge to get it out of the deck. I want to speed up my ability to kill this guy. Should have started with dual cast. Oops. Now we want to kill him next turn. Which we'll do. Alright, this deck is good. Probably just a cool-headed. We do want card draw. I don't necessarily have the energy aside from one fight. We bricked on that, but Smoke Bomb might be okay in some of these hallways. I think we take a cool headed over an overclock. I think we're definitely going this route, so I don't want to spend money here. Let's just stick with the original plan. This fight is not too bad. This is probably the easiest hard pool. We could static discharge Glacier. Take a little bit of damage, but that's fine. I'm willing to give up a lightning to try to prevent some more damage here. I know we're not preventing all of it, but... pretty straightforward turn. Wish we had more frost orbs. I thought with... you'd think with a glacier and two cool-headeds that I'd have more frost orbs, but apparently not. Is that really the first claw I've played? Interesting. I think instead of playing a zap, we take four defense here. Wait, does he get pretty unlucky not to kill him here? Let's make it so there's no luck factor here. And then we can finish. Can we finish this fight? 7 times 1, 2, 3. 35. It's not guaranteed. I probably want dual cast. Hey, look. Look at that. Claw? I would take another glacier, I think. Yeah. I would probably take a turbo at this point. We have enough high cost stuff that it makes sense. I'll do glacier instead of hit there. I can probably smoke bomb this fight if it looks like it's gonna go sour. It's just a normal fight. It's not like I'm getting huge rewards here. Like, I'm already taking enough damage here that I might just smoke bomb it. If I don't get into glacier here, I think I should smoke bomb. And I could heal 6 here by doing that. So I'm already blocking the 6, but then I add... the thing is, this guy's gonna get out of control pretty fast. I'm getting vulnerable as well. This is a good candidate. The immediate punish for whatever. 2 glaciers is not fun. I think we're gonna have to use this here, unfortunately. I need all those frost orbs in. What a bad turn. Do I want to play 3 attacks this turn, or do I want to get Static Discharge and Bias Cog? I'm pretty sure we just want to get these in. Oh, I can play 3 anyway. Consume Cool-Headed? This fight's solved. It ended up not being too bad, right? Come on, dude. Whatever. One of them was supposed to hit the other one. I guess we just take a little bit of more damage. Most of the time that should work out, but not today, apparently. You fucking clawed, bitch. Fuck you. Look at that, I killed the avocado before the rat. Ah, that's a fucking weird decision. Kinda feel like the defrag is bait here. Like, I already get what defrag's doing out of consume. It is expensive. I kind of feel like it's turbo here, but steam barrier makes a little bit of sense with the kunai and the fact that my deck is very expensive and the fact that it is upgraded already. Would be okay into that fight. Turbo does have the downside of the void, but I don't think we care too much about that. Like, I play a few consumes and then I'm good to go. I think it's just turbo. And we hope we don't brick on when we draw it, but I have double card draw. I mean, on that note, like, would it be better to upgrade a cool-headed? Would it be crazy to do that over consume? I think I would upgrade consume over bias cog because this is a card that I'm trying to build around. Problem is, right now the turbo has a chance to brick. If I can cool-headed and draw more with it, it has less of a chance to brick. It also does have synergy with the claw. I just draw them more often. In the upcoming fights, I actually think drawing is more important, so I'm going to upgrade cool-headed first. Have I not fought an elite yet? I guess these are our two elites, right? Okay. This fight should hopefully not be bad. So we'll already see hopefully some value here. We might as well static discharge instead of glacier here and just take the damage, I think. It's 4 damage for a ton of stuff. I think we attack here. I'll just get another one of these in. See, we brick turbo here. It's unfortunate, but I mean, look at how many ways we couldn't have brick. We just happen to have horrible RNG. What are you going to do? We will bias cog here. I'm going to hit here. I'm just getting more value out of doing it over there. I arguably shouldn't do that defend, but we'll see. This fight's going a lot worse than it should. I really wish I could consume this turn. That's a bad breakpoint though, of the 9. But we get to win here, and unfortunately I don't want to finish the fight now, but I have to. Charge battery could work. I don't know though. Similar to turbo. Yeah, I think it's okay though. I have a kunai. I proc the kunai well enough. And it has a synergy with my high cost deck. I don't know if we'll be able to get away with no... We have no potions. What the hell, man? Did I really go through all of these fights without getting one? I haven't gotten one since the smoke bomb, right? Well, I think we have to heal, is what I'm getting at. I am still going to take the elite on, though. Am I? Do we think I can actually take two on here? I mean, I can take the one on. I'll probably lose quite a lot of health. Let's think, like... Book of Stabbing is my best fight. I probably don't get wrecked in that one as long as I draw Static Discharge somewhat early. Slavers will wreck me, though. Gremlin Knob, it's a toss-up. Depends on if he wants to just continuously attack me or not. I mean, I'm not too bad into the Gremlin fight most of the time, I feel, but there's a decent chance just the RNG kills me. I sure haven't taken on a lot of elites. But it's risky. It's like, if I'll take a ton of damage most likely in any of these fights. And I may just die to slavers. I mean, how do I beat the slavers? I currently can't, I don't think, without a potion. Yeah, I will get wrecked by them. I think we have to go left here and go for that shop. It's I really don't like it, but I'll probably have to take it and it does get me out of the problem of bull shops, but it's not great. Like, then I'm just going to a hallway after. I do want, if I take the wing beats, I want to go here. And I'd probably go here. I guess what I could do is I go here, 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 here. Then my wing boots are gone, but I get a green guy out of the way, and Act 3 is pretty open. I think I'm pretty good into this fight. I think that's the plan. So let's upgrade Consume, I guess. I think we're trying to... Man, I don't know, though. Let's go here, see what it gets us. That's probably worth it. That allows us to definitely do some setup. Okay. I think I'm feeling okay about fighting this elite then. Like, Slavers is now doable with those. Yeah, let's go. Of course, it's Slavers. Do I want to take three here to get three attacks in versus the Glacier? I think I do. Gotta deal damage, right? I think we draw. Try to get Apparition or else... Yeah, I don't know what else we can do. I've played two attacks. Unless I draw into specifically Claw, though, I can't play a third, and I got one draw. So if I draw here on my last energy... Bad, 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 good, good. Yeah, so we don't draw. But do I survive? I'm taking fucking 22, 34 damage. Biased Cog gets me less defense immediately than a charge battery or a defend would get, but it does up my damage. And it makes, like, I think we just bias Cog here. I survive. Definitely means we're not taking the elite on here. I think we just go... I guess we just go here. And then there. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Assuming I live, which is quite the assumption. Because now I'm vulnerable. Definitely can't brick on Apparition here. Okay, we get Apparition. God, I need to get that fucking Glacier in. I can't, though. Realistically, I can't. I could. But I'm probably getting Apparition next turn. 5 out of 8. If I don't get it, though, I'm dead if I don't do Glacier. If I do Glacier now... I still Apparition, I'm not going to dual cast. So I Glacier to get the Frost next turn. To allow me to survive hits from them if I don't get Apparition. If I do get Apparition, we're fine. If I don't, I think I can survive with a Consume, right? Because I'll be down to 4x3, 12, but then I can replenish back up to 7x3, 21. Honestly, I'm... vulnerable for two turns, though, it might not work. I definitely have to also, like, definitely... Like, I'll claw this guy, probably, and then just hope I 1 out of 3 him. Alternate plays are I Strike Claw doesn't kill him, unfortunately. I had to get weak and vulnerable, of course. Yeah, I think it's just Apparition, Glacier, Claw. Hope that this hits. It does. So we're got a fighting chance here if I don't hit Apparition. But I hit it. So I probably will turbo this turn. Just get everything out. Do I want to take damage here? 21. So I get 21, I get take 3 damage. I'm down to... I don't think we want to. Because this fight's going to go on for a little bit still. And I can do the same play that I'm thinking of this... these other turns. Let's get that guy dead first, I think. Got him. We are still on a bit of a timer here. Because we're losing focus. But that's probably not too bad. We don't want to kill this turn. So we'll kill next turn. Alright, we got through it. Penneb is probably not amazing for this deck. At least we got a potion, a good one. God, that's expensive, but it's probably worth. I don't think a loop or another discharge is worth it. I mean, a loop might be into, in the context that we are coming up on this fight, a loop might be better. You know, I can loop Frost Orb, hopefully. Anything I loop is going to be okay. I don't know, though. It's almost... if I don't upgrade it, which... I don't know that I would upgrade it. Right now, I still want probably... Pious Cog wants to be upgraded. It's probably not a priority upgrade at the moment, because Pious Cog isn't really going to get played at a time when it matters in this fight, I feel. I don't know. Maybe it will. Kind of feel like I just want to upgrade the Cool-Headed that I still don't have upgraded. Equilibrium is nice because it doesn't need an upgrade. Loop kind of needs an upgrade. So, like, I could already upgrade the Cool-Headed. I have Apparitions that could get upgraded. Bias Cog could still get upgraded. I don't think I want to add another card that wants to be upgraded. So let's add an Equilibrium. I will upgrade here. And we'll... I mean, I don't get much from Rest when I'm on 39 max HP. I think we just upgrade the Cool-Headed first. And then I'll go to the shop, see if I can cash in on anything. Defrag, another card that needs to be upgraded, but not completely out of the question. That's a Frozen Eye. I have to imagine we just take Frozen Eye. That's like game winning. Seek is good too. But Frozen Eye is kind of just like Seek. Like every turn. I mean, it isn't, but... can I just get both of them? That's 200... I could just get both of them. It's not like I need much else. I mean, the heal might be nice, and I definitely don't have to rest. Blessing of the Forge, it's alright. Colorless is alright. I don't need those attacks. I don't need anything else here. I don't need the defrag, I don't think. Do I need removes? Removes wouldn't be horrible. Strikes could probably... strikes are still giving me okay value, though. Eventually, they won't. Deck size is 27. This is a deck that wants to be thin, for sure. We have a lot of cards that benefit from being seen often, which are Consume and the Claws. And also, we just want to see Apparition soon, typically. So thin deck is good. There is some anti-synergy in Turbo being played, because the Voids will cycle in more often. with the thin deck. I think I'm just going to take the Frozen Eye for sure. There's just no way I'm not taking that. It's too good of an artifact. And the question is, I could do Potion Remove or just Seek. That's the choices. This basically represents an upgrade, and then... I mean, the Seek... Seek with Apparitions, though, is really good. Seek with a Consume might be needed. Seek Biased Cog. If I get a Core Surge, then I upgrade the Seek. I think I just take Seek. Seek is too powerful of a card. Now, I am on 11 health. How risky is it for me to make an upgrade here? Because I don't get that much on heal. Also, the Distilled Chaos with the Frozen Eye is going to be really good if I remember to actually, you know, use it. The thing is, I don't have any super necessary upgrades right now. Like, I could upgrade an Apparition. Probably I should. I think I'm overestimating my ability to block the Hyper Beam. Yeah, let's upgrade one Appa. And hopefully it's one that we can preserve. We'll know with Frozen Eye. So I'm going to get into the habit of looking through these each turn. Next turn sucks. We might just lose because of it. Wait, okay, we have a Cool Headed. We have an Equilibrium. So next turn doesn't have to God, this is a rough fucking 10 cards to get through here at 11 health. Because he'll attack next turn. And the guys might as well. Well, I do have the 4 slots. I could Cool-Headed Glacier. I don't think it's that bad that I don't have a Sweeping Beam and Strike in hand. Or that I don't play them. I could always Turbo if I need to play them for some reason. So, we Glacier Cool-Headed this turn. Fills us with 3 Frost Orbs. So I draw them, then I draw these next turn. Still, like, so I consume, but I lose a Frost Orb if I do that. Fuck. Am I gonna have to Bias Cog early here? I mean, this is just trash. So what if I turbo this turn to get the Sweeping Beam to draw one more card? Then I draw a strike. This is fucking abysmal, man. Look at this shit. All the apparitions down there. Seek. The other Glacier and the Cool-Headed. Even the fucking charge battery, like... Okay, we have the Distilled Chaos, though. Does that get us anything? So, I'm probably almost certainly Cool-Heading this turn, so we draw out a dual cast next turn minimum. I could... Yeah, so this is what I would have to do. I would have to do my Cool-Headed, I draw these, then I'd have to turbo, do the... draw there, that way I draw those 5, and then Distilled Chaos has the option to get me Apparition. I think that's the only play to make here. Or I could Equilibrium now. That's not a bad play either, I didn't really consider that. Because then I have Sweeping Beam next turn, I have the defense from Glacier, I have a Turbo to make a big turn. Even though my big turn is, wait, what? Did that change my draw order? No, I just didn't click the right thing. So my big draw... I think actually the Equilibrium here works. Yeah, we'll do the equilibrium. That way I can also consume before Glacier. Every single one of them attack. Holy fuck. Jesus. Well, we might have to go for that apparition. Let's do some calculations, I guess. 7 block. 7 block at base. I turbo that out. I can Glacier and then dual cast, so... Because the shitty thing is, like, I don't want to burn this particular apparition. Like, my RNG is not being... Like, I'm not going to tilt, okay? I'm not going to tilt, but I just want to mention it. Throw it out in the air. My RNG is fucking me right in the face right now. Like, not only are you just making this so hard on me, you give me that apparition as the one that I would have to burn. So we have to figure out a way to not burn that this turn. So let's do that. How much damage is incoming? 16 twice, so that's 32. 32. And I have 11 health. But I don't want to take any damage if I don't have to, but I'm probably going to have to if I don't apparition. But let's just do the actual calculations. So we got 7. I turbo and play that first. I consume first. I don't glacier first. So, but we'll think 7 there. I consume and then I glacier for. So this goes up to these are doing 5 block. They evoke for 8. So I'll have this many slots. Glacier makes that. It evokes that. I can then dual cast. So I have 3 frost orbs. I dual cast and I get 16. Then I have 2 left over, so 26. 26 plus 7 is 33, which is full block. Alright, so that's the turn. Let me think if I don't dual cast here. So 7 plus 5. Or 7 plus 15 is 22. I would take 10, go down to 1 health. Nah. I don't need to burn artifact on this guy. We just want to kill these guys because they're going to probably take some pretty good cards. Alright, now I don't have to play that, so that's really good. We have a horrible turn here. What are they going to take? They're just going to take my Seek, and then I think they can only take from your draw pile, not your discard pile, right? So they're either, if they can take from the discard pile, they'll take Cog. If not, they'll take either Glacier or Capacitor, I guess. Both cards, I don't want any of these cards, I do not want them to take, but either way, we're drawing our apparitions next turn, so those will just be sort of getting played. Still taking a while to get set up here. I don't think I need to burn this potion yet. We're probably just gonna double apparition. Do I draw here? I mean, there's not huge benefit in double apparitioning because next turn this guy's not attacking. It's really unfortunate the attack patterns I've been kind of fucked in the face here with again, where they're all attacking at once, right? But I don't know. We got the apparition, so it's not that. Not that big of a deal. We don't know what we're drawing next turn, largely, so I don't think we charge battery. I think we capacitor instead of zap, right? Because I don't want to redraw this. I don't know if we're going to be able to make much use of static discharge now that our health is that low. Wow, they're still attacking. I guess that's all they do now, right? Well, they can still defend. I mean, I'll full block here, but the turn coming up, are we going to be able to deal with that? Apparition's at the very bottom of the deck again. Or not again, but now it's like it's at the bottom and we don't want it to be at the bottom. Well, we can get Frost Orb there at least. Beyond that, we're kind of fucked. Do I need to buy a Cog is what I'm thinking of right now. So what's the deck size at this point? It's 5. If I play that, 4. 4, 9. This burns out, so 13. That burns out, but I may not burn it out. So we'll say 13 and 18 or 17, depending on how you look at it. And then 19 or 20, depending on how you look at it. I draw 5 a turn, but I can draw 2 every now and then. I'm just trying to think. I could probably consume often enough that I at least stalemate the biased cog downfall, but is that going to be a winning play? I don't think so. I think we really are trying to fill our deck up with Frost Orbs and keep scaling, and a biased cog I think loses us the game. If I have to play biased cog here, I think we just lose anyway, right? Well, either way, we're clawing. I know that much. I'm not dual casting. I'm striking. I'm defending. Next turn, I can probably Distilled Chaos. It does draw me a Void, though, so we'll have to think about that. But I do want to get that consumed. So, like, if I play this, I'll draw 2. And then we'll just probably want to Equilibrium. And I can Turbo after we draw the Void, actually. That'll work. Comes the motherfucking Hyper Beam. Beam Cells coming up. So we want to Cool-Headed first, right? And then Equilibrium. Oh, we'll do that first, actually. What card are you holding? Seek. I should have killed that guy. Just mistakes all around. So I'm at 20 now. Let me double check. I have 20. And then 30. Yeah, we're going to have to do this. What? It preserved it? I thought it would just put it in the hand. Well. Oh well. So, I guess let's see if I even need the turbo now then. So, 8 times 4 is 32 plus 17 is 49 plus 11 is... So 49 minus 58, what's that? So 9 minus 58 is 47. So I'd live, but I would go down quite a lot of health. I think we want to turbo defend just to save a little bit of health here. Unless I want to get hit. I mean, I still get hit anyway, right? Yeah, let's turbo defend zap. Or... Nah, I was going to say I could get Seek, but no, I think we turbo defend zap. Do we want to wait for Glacier? Sh- Should I charge battery? There's a chance I draw like two voids a turn after and I'm pretty fucked. I really want that glacier next turn, but I also want to be able to play it. But I'd also love... I'd love to get my dex up. It's probably not that important to get my dexterity up. So I'm thinking what we do is charge battery, two strikes. I put the strikes on this guy. No, I think actually we put the strike here. And we don't seek. We charge battery and we hit... Alright, where are those voids? Seek, defend, cool-headed. Glacier, defend, cool-headed. I can draw and re-turbo, but I don't need to because I'm just trying to seek. That should be full block, right? Yeah. Sorry. So, next turn's pretty straightforward. We just claw, attack, consume. I don't think we need to do anything here. Then I don't want to keep creating voids if I don't have to. Alright. And... consume for sure. Try to get that other glacier. I wish it would stick in the hand. We did... I should have looked at what I was... drawing. That was played a little too fast there. Well, we know we can do that. 24 by 2. I'm pretty sure we blocked that. I'm doing 22 by 2, but then I just charge battery and I'm good. I could sweeping beam equilibrium because we don't know what we're drawing, but I could just keep the bias cog. I'm at a point now where I can play bias cog. And I may need to. So I think we sweeping beam equilibrium, then I'll also have a defend for next turn on top of whatever gets drawn. But I don't want to cog yet, I don't feel. We might as well cog on a turn he's attacking. That's quite a lot. But I do have the glacier, I'm pretty sure. I feel like if I can delay the cog, I should, because I'm still not even halfway through his health. And I don't necessarily, without getting hit, I only have sap to generate these, and as I am forced to play glaciers and stuff, I may be losing lightning orbs. So, like, the fight doesn't end as quickly as you think. And he does keep scaling, too, so, like, we can't, at the same time, we can't really fuck around that much. What is the stuff coming up? So we have consume coming up. I don't want to play that this turn, most likely. But I also... I can glacier... What if I do want to do the consume this turn? I don't think I do, because I don't want to evoke these things. So how much do we got to block here? We got 11 by 4, so 44. We got some block to make up here. That's 26 we got to make up. A single glacier does it. What if we just glacier zap? We'll lose one lightning and replace one. I think that's fine. This is where loop would be good too, by the way. So, this is a pretty easy consume. Do we want to... So we have the apparition coming up if I need it. It might be nice just to equilibrium glacier though. Equilibrium for the glacier. I think we want to consume though. That'll greatly increase our damage. And we'll just attack to get some more damage as well. So now we're getting... Now we can definitely play cog whenever it comes around again. Do I need the Appa here? I got 14 by 5. So 50. 50. And then 4 times 5 is 20. So 70. He's doing over 70. He's doing 70. No, he's not doing over 70. He's doing 64. So I don't actually have to evoke here, which I probably don't want to. I could dual cast. Why don't we dual cast? Just speed things up. Then I can actually play my cool headed. Try to draw back through the deck. Claw for the finish. Eh, whatever. In most fights, that's not going to matter, but that is definitely a mistake. I was too excited to play the damn claw. That is an all for one. Still don't... I mean, honestly, I don't have great damage because of Zap being my only realistic generator of lightning. So one problem with static discharge with apparitions is it really isn't kind of come into play at all, almost. So like, there's a decent argument that Beam Cell and these claws are our main source of damage. Or at least a source of damage, which makes All for One decent. We really want an energy artifact, I think. Hyper Beam is out of the question, I think. Seek is always doable. I mean, Seek with the apparitions, pretty safe, but I'm thinking, like, these fights go on. That fight went on pretty damn long, and that is not going to win against the heart. Or even something like a giant head. So I think we All for One. We could Busted Crown. I could also just Panda's Box. It's not an energy artifact, but... You know, these strikes... They're alright. With the Pendib and the Kunai and Oramundle Fan, they're not great. It's definitely not Shitbark. Busted Crown could be okay, because... I do want the energy, like I said. This All for One is tough to play without it. I mean, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2 cost, plus I draw okay with the cool-headed. So there's a lot of reason to have energy, even with the turbo in the deck. It's just one turbo. I think we take the crown. I think that it's quite nice here. I don't really need that much more cards to round this deck out. I actually have the full deck, I think. It just needs energy. So crown it is. So we have our green shard out of the way. We have the ability to take on as many elites as we want, which I will want to. We're a little light on relics, and it's time to make up the fact that that is so. Plus, we want to be rewarded for getting our green shard out of the way, which with the freedom to do the map that we want. The freedom of movement, as a sovereign citizen would say. You're blocking my freedom of movement! Three elites only on the left path. So that is what we'll do. I don't want that when I can't cash in on it. Plus, I don't like Act 3 events, and I like Act 3 hallways. Even if it's Busted Crown, these are just going to be typically not adding a curse to my deck, typically not taking 26 damage or whatever it is. You know, we'll take it. So we're going to go up this way. Here it's debatable if we'll go there or there. Both of them have a shop defense, and both of them have a thing. It just depends on when I need to do either of those things. It's most likely going to be this way. Let me go here, here. This is a great path. So let's do that. Now, wouldn't that have sucked if, say, like this guy was green? So it's nice sometimes to get that green thing out of the way. This is a pretty obvious apparition. The question is, what else? Do I charge battery for more energy next turn? No, this is a bad all for one. So we do that. We glacier the capacitor. This fight, I think we just have to do Bias Cog, unfortunately. We really need to get Bias Cog upgraded now, because now it is kind of a liability to have this on 4. I just don't want to take all this damage this turn. I'm still taking a lot of damage anyhow, but... I just don't want to take all the damage. I guess we want that guy dead since he's getting more strength. I really hope this fight doesn't end us. This is by far the worst normal fight we could have ran into, other than... eventually transient could be pretty bad too. Okay, well this is pretty easy turn. Not much to think about, I guess. Other than just where do I put my claws, but might as well do the dude that's scaling. God, this fight's really bad for me. Drawn to strike and beam cell. Wonder if I need to apparition here. It'd be nice to be able to save that. I could at least get my dexterity scaling so that I'm not just permanently anti-scaling in this fight. I think that would be good. I don't think we're going to kill him with lightning orbs. We're going to kill him with claws. Yeah, so I could cool-headed. I get my 3 attacks in. And I guess we may just... I could turbo here to get the glacier in. I'm still not really full blocking though. If I do that, I may just have to blow this apparition. I mean, how much? So let's say I do this. I get 4. Can't kill anyone right here. But I'll get an additional 4 from that. So we're looking at 12, 16. And then I could get 20, 24, and then 20, 24, and it would be 8, which would be 36. Two, three, four, five. I have 1 energy left over. Well, that's what I have to do. There's not really anything else I can do. So, and do that. So do I need apparition here? So let me double check this. 12, 4 times 6. No, that's 5. That's 20, so I have 32. And they're doing 15, 29, fucking 40. Kind of want to get this zap in. I also kind of want to live. I don't insert her next turn either, so it's like I would lose the zap anyhow with the consume unless I'm going to dual cast. I'm only dual casting a lightning there. I guess I'm still apparitioning here. It's shitty, but whatever. I don't want to lose health. My health is a very important resource at this point. I could Hold the Seek. We're not going to be able to proc anything here. We're going to do that. That is a big help right now. What if I cool hit it and I lose that? Oh, but I have to do that to get Static Discharge. If I want to play that and get it out of here. I guess I could Seek here and just get Static Discharge out of the way. So I Sweeping Beam, Seek, and then I draw. Or I cycle a new deck. We'll get a new thing. I really want to preserve this. Because it's like my main thing of damage right now. Although I could 1 out of 3 into killing this guy right now, which would help quite a lot. I think we just want to get this out of here. And I'll probably be getting hit. I have no apparitions left. I'm still anti-scaling my stuff. Oh my god. Well, All for One has been a complete boner so far. Somehow, with 1, 2, 3, 4 zero costs, I have drawn all of them before All of One twice now. Just throwing that out there. And now I'm going to... good thing they put the Void at the very top. That's fun. That's fun. Fuck. Oh, what do I do here? Like a Glacier Leap Equilibrium. How much does that get me? It evokes that, which sucks, but what am I going to do there? It evokes that, so we're looking at 8. And then, five by 35. So it's 18 plus 25. So 18 plus 20 is 38 plus 5 is 43 with just a glacier. And then what else? I mean, I can't even hurt him this turn. I can barely hurt him this turn. How much damage is coming in? 26, 30, 40, 56. Okay, 56. God, I need to write all this down. And how much? I've already forgot how much I'm blocking. So 5 times 5, 25 plus 8. Is 33 plus 10 is 43, or 56. But I could let myself get hit, is the thing. What if I dual class Glacier cool headed to draw this? I think I like that. Then I get Glacier the following turn. And then I get hit for the damage. And then I actually have some damage here. We can get the beam cell going. Yeah. That should be good, because we can kill the guy in the middle. Oh, that was pen-nibbed. I could try to work on this guy, actually, because how much am I blocking with the Glacier? I evoke for 14. So 14 plus 16 is 30. And then I have 42. That should be enough. Oh, and I can just kill this guy. Sweet. We did it. What a fucking fight. Well, I don't think a loop is out of the question. I think a loop is fine to take. Man, I wonder if I'm so slow for these fights that these fights are worse than I'm thinking they are. And I could actually just abort and go this way now. Like, if this fight proves to be bad, then that's absolutely what I'll do. Barskog will be getting played. Oh, would you look at that? A third time where my all for one hits no zero cost. This is insanely bad RNG, by the way. Come on, dude. What are you fucking doing? Let's do that. So I got 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I really don't want to keep taking hits. I could block with the defend and just go loop. Over zap? I think so. So I could seek something out. You're doing 21. 13, 14, 15. I could just seek the, how are we going to do damage? I think I should, if I equilibrium, I can actually get this all for one to get me some value. So why don't we seek in the static discharge and then I equilibrium biased cog, because I do need to generate some damage. That makes sense. Oh wait, I miscalculated that. Well, that's pretty bad. That was not the ideal play. My brain is like hurting right now. It's legitimately hurting. Only getting claw value technically, unless I want turbo value out of the all for one. That's questionable. Well, we got these apparitions coming up actually each turn, which would be nice, unless I want to draw one right now, because I don't really block him here. I don't want to take damage this fight. Beam still is way down there, so just do that. We know that's happening. Do I want to draw Appa this turn is the question. Do I want to draw Consume? Probably do. So what are we doing here? Can't actually draw Consume. I could still full block here. I don't need the capacitor. I can also, yeah, let's just all for one. I'll get the extra energy for next turn. I like that. We'll consume double Appa strike. I mean, if they're gonna be ethereal anyway, might as well, right? We want to preserve that if we can. It looks like we can, because he's just exactly lethaled here. All right, fairy in a bottle. It's all right. I don't think we want to stack. By the time stack would be good, the deck should be online already. It's the help before then that we need. That fight went okay. I don't know if I want to take three of these on, though. Busted Crown really does make these not that worth it. I mean, I'm getting gold still. What fights do screw me? I don't think many fights screw me, though. Transient would be the hardest one. Because I only have the three apparitions, and I don't deal quite enough damage fast enough to probably survive that fight, which is a problem. Maybe Panda's Box was better. I don't know. It's tough to say. I mean, I've definitely liked having the extra energy in these fights. I don't know why I'm opening that up. Well, We need something. Problem is, if I go through here, I could brick pretty hard here. These, I don't care about bricking on my one card offering. What I care about is getting some gold, because right now I don't have much gold. And I could get gold by the time I'm there and actually try to find something. So I think we just keep doing the normals. This is not a good fight for us. Are you shitting me? Again, the all for one before all the... I don't know. So think about how bad my RNG is. I have 4 zero costs in this deck. Or at least 4 relevant ones. And in every single fight, the first pass through, I have gotten all for one before them every single time. That is a 1 out of 5, you know, times however many fights that is. It's actually ridiculous. So I'm getting absolutely... I'm really not getting any value out of the all for one. The thought was that it's going to help me scale my damage and actually quicken my damage a bit, but in fact all it's doing is delaying my draws to actual cards. Because all I'm getting is a fucking two cost 10 damage card. What, I could have had a Seek instead of that. I don't know though. Do you judge the outcome, or do you judge what should have happened? What should have happened is I don't low roll a 1 out of 5 every single fight. Who knows? Because certainly Seek early would have been great. That's a lot of damage, and I need to get to that apparition, but I can't get it to it this turn. I have this. It doesn't get me that much health back. Do I benefit from drawing here? I don't know that I do. I mean, I have the Seek that I can probably just use for an apparition next turn if I need to. So we should just try to prevent as much damage this turn as we can. The way we do that is charge battery, defend Glacier. And we fucking pop the goddamn thing. What a stupid fight. Act 3 normals are supposed to be easy. What a stupid fucking fight. Well, we definitely... Why can't they do that? Turn 1. Now they're all just... I have all this defense. Look what they're doing. My draw is actually so bad here that even equilibrating this all for 1, still I can't get a 0 cost out of it. I guess I technically... Yeah, it wouldn't even work because Seek stays in the hand, so it's like... Oh, this RNG. At least we have the apparition next turn. I don't know that there's much to do other than equilibrium all for one, unless we think a glacier's better. Sucks. Maybe I just Seek something here. What could I Seek? I could Seek the consume. I could Seek consume equilibrium. Then I have... Yeah, even then it doesn't make much sense. But Seek Consume is probably just needed. It's so far down there. And we do want to get it into play. Why does it show there? And I guess we just all for one get the horrible... I guess we get Pen Nib value. Yay. Yeah, because I actually don't think we have any benefit from equilibrating here. Because I'm just using Apparition anyway next turn. Definitely using that. Not much to think about there. Zap, loop, cool-headed. Cool-headed zap. Probably cool-headed zap. Because we want the zap in the back. I don't want to draw here, right? Yeah, we want the zap in, we want the loop in. Do I upgrade loop before I upgrade biased cog? That would be a decent question. Alright, well, we have to do this. There's all my zero costs. We'll try to get that guy. Turbo's been fucking dud central here. We still want to try to kill this guy. Eight, seven. We should be fine here. Next turn we get Glacier. Question is that going to be enough? I would like to draw here. We want to keep drawing because we're in Bias Cog. We don't have time. The AoE, I guess, doesn't do much here. I was going to AoE, but I'm like, should I? Well, we get Claw next turn if I do. So I should. Okay. I need to make sure I don't draw cards or else the all for one is not going to get any value, but I can actually get some pretty good all for one value. So we'll do it here, I guess, because the other guy has more stuff. So I got 30. Yeah, we got enough to block. Do I equilibrium here? I don't think so. I think we just do the damage. Sure. Stupid. Oh, dude, I am open to it. Again, it's a 1 out of 6. It's a 1 out of 6. And the all for one is still not getting any value. Relevantly, at least. Like, by the time it comes, it's completely irrelevant. Alright, so the both of these get me enough. Did we really have to run into this fight again? We have apparition next turn. I guess we just lose our zap, but I don't want to blow that apparition. This is really hard not to tilt. Like, so however, now it's a 1 out of 6 on top of all those 1 out of 5s that I keep low rolling on. I need a hologram in this deck. Hologram would mitigate these low rolls so much better. Well, probably Apparition. And Frozen Eye makes these runs last so long. I guess we biased Cog. Consume is like pretty far down there. Though I could seek. I could cool-headed seek. I think I like that. I can seek out the consume. And then I don't have to biased Cog. And I can just apparition and. I don't know. The next turn's really bad though. I kind of regret how I just did this turn. I might just have to Bias Cog instead of Apparition here. And if I Bias Cog, it's 9 by 3, which should block all that, but then I actually get better block for next turn, and I don't die next turn. But definitely, I definitely didn't play this turn well, and it might cost me the game if they all attack here. Well, they don't all attack. start with the... Well, doesn't matter, does it? Yeah, that's just... I'll survive. Actually, I block. Okay, I miscalculated that. Drawn to turbocharged battery. Probably will need to do that. A lot of damage coming in. It's 28. It's 30, 42. 42, I have 21. I need to get another 21. You can do that with this. Yeah, let's just do that then. So I get... I could take a damage here just to generate some actual lightning. I think that's worth it, and I don't think it's worth turboing for that. That is way more damage than I thought it was. Holy shit, I could have died there. In fact, with another fight and an elite, I probably will die now because of that mistake. Oh well, I mean, what... So much of the value of this deck that should have been there, at least some of these fights, was hard. You know, what can I do? What can I do when that shit happens? I even added a third Claude to my deck, and I... Whatever. Now, let's get the other Claw in here. I can get the Apparition played. Let's kill one of these. Definitely have to consume. Do we just equilibrium otherwise? Or should I zap? Consume equilibrium, I think. That's a turn. I can draw twice to get the apparition if I need it. Probably we want to do that anyway because the all for one is here. So I can actually have a turn that I've been wanting to have. Can I draw? Do I have a sweeping beam in here? Do I have any other draw? So just draw four. Okay. Well. Claw will do more than all for one, so... Yeah, let's do... That. That. Can't draw more here. Back the single claw. Which will be doing 22... So we have 26 and 39 I have to block. I got 21. I got 33 right now. So we'll definitely... Do I want Apparition for next turn? I probably don't need it for next turn. So why don't I just... Let's say I attack this guy twice for 12. He goes down to 8 health. I have to miss 3 times to not kill him. And if I do miss 3 times... Well, then I'm just dead. Do I need to be that greedy? Because I'm still running out of time in this fight. I've passed up most of my damage. I don't think I need to make that risk here. I don't think I need Apparition next turn, because if I do dry, we'll have Glacier next turn. And they'll be pretty close to dying. And they might just die anyway, depending on how these shake out. So I'm going to Turbo Cool-Headed that. That was as bad as it could have gone with the hits. Actually, maybe it's not. Maybe it actually isn't. Fuck you. Jesus. Power potion's good. Sweeping beam is like almost good. Is it good enough? It does draw. It is an attack. I think what we'd rather have is a compile driver, which we haven't even seen a single one on this run. So weird. Oh, we're probably dead here. Well, at least we drew claws before All for One for once. This happens to be in the very last hand, so that's fun. But, you know, it's technically for the very first time in this entire run, you know, fucking five fights into Act 3 here. We finally did it. We finally didn't lose a 1 out of 6. Go us. I would like... What do I do? Why don't I cool-headed an equilibrium so that I have the apparition? It's either that or do I need to? And I already have a glacier coming up. So there's really no point in equilibrium, I guess. But we still want a cool-headed, and I'll just glacier. Well, I guess the question is if I want apparition because I'm on 2 health. Because I draw here. Yeah, I mean, I'm not adding any power to the deck, so it's not like glacier. I guess we do the doo-doo. The equilibrium. Not great though. Probably should have saved the claws then, because then I could have procced Kunai and Ornamental Fan. That's a problem. Like, this is one thing I've noticed. It's like there to get a really high win rate on this game, you have to spend like 3 hours in every run, and I don't like to do that. I'm already like an hour 40 into this run, and that's too. I don't like spending this much time on a single run in a game. You know? I don't know. Anyway, I could just do Apparition, Capacitor, Glacier Loop. Next turn's not so good. But I don't know that I can get around any of that. Yeah. I can't glacier. Fuck. I need to be able to draw one more. I think I have to try to get a draw-based power here. I could either get Heat Sinks or Machine Learning. I could also get Buffer. Buffer works. This hits for one. What hits first though? Does the Frost Orb come in play before the Constricted? I believe it does, so I'll block here, and I do have the ability to do this loop. God, how am I going to survive, though? Even with the buffer, I don't think I survive, right? The loop isn't going to help me. I think I still have to glacier. I guess I should have creative AI. I don't know. I don't know what gets me out of any of this. Nothing, really. I don't know. I don't know much. I'm just dead here. I'm just dead. Because I can't block this. I needed to not play Capacitor, actually, because then I could have... You know what? I've got so far in this run. I know it's a reload, but I don't know. I want to, like... I want to play this properly. So, we cool-headed. We equilibrium. That's it. And now I do not Capacitor. I claw, I strike, I apparition, and I glacier. And now I sweeping beam. Oh fuck, I didn't do the power potion. Alright, you gotta give me a mulligan here. Actually, yeah. I wanted to replay it as it was. I wonder though now if it's not gonna give me buffer. I think it doesn't. But we'll find out. If I can't get buffer, then I'm not gonna like save scum it until it gives me a good power. I wanted to replay it as it was, but I don't think it's actually gonna let me do that. So I got, let's claw, strike. Let me see if it gives me buffer here. It does, so we'll be able to replay it as I wanted to. And then apparition, glacier. So then I sweeping beam, I zap, I dual cast, now I prevent the buffer and I have a fighting chance. And I can apparition, consume, I guess we charge battery for next turn? And we want to seek. We want to draw and then seek. Now we're fucking talking. See, this is what should have been happening. All those other fights, I could have saved so much health if I could have had turns like that into things like Jawworm and fucking guys that need to die fast. Unfortunately for this guy, he has a ton of health, so I don't get to kill him straight out, but I sure go a far way, don't I? So definitely no static discharge, though I might still turbo to not redraw it. I don't know, it would add... Nah, it wouldn't make any sense because then I'm adding a void. Hopefully we can kill this guy. Yeah, this will be the moment of truth. We just glacier equilibrium. There's not a better turn that I can put together there. And... claw would be a kill. And we got the pen nib, which, it's alright. Oh, we do get a Kapow Trevor. I'll take that. Definitely take that. Alright, moment of truth. Can we get through an elite on 2 health here? Let me start with Apparition, so that answer is yes. What's the turn look like otherwise? We got another Apparition coming up, so I don't need to, like, Glacier right now or anything. Though... it would be nice if I could not play this Apparition that turn if I can. Depends on if he attacks or not. He might not attack. So we might as well start with the strike, I guess. Does that actually get us more damage? Because this would be 4. This would be 4. And then I get 9, so 4 plus 9 is 13, or 12 plus 4 is... 16. Wait, what was it? It was 8 plus 9, 17. So it actually is better to beam cell here before the strike. And I guess we'll just zap Appa. Oh god, I'm taking a damage by doing that. Well, I don't know. I think we need the damage. Oh, wait.
He attacks twice!
Not like this. Yeah, accurate. Well, whatever. My brain only has so much capacity. Like, that, I had to fucking fight my ass off on that run anyway to even get where we are at. Plus, we reloaded anyway, so it's not even a legit run. So, whatever. I don't really know what I could have done that much differently on that run. Like, certainly the apparitions may have been a bad call. All for One ended up being a bad call, but I don't think it was a bad call, because I shouldn't have low rolled that hard. It's like a fraction of a single percent that I roll that bad, right? I mean, what's it's a 1 out of 5 into a 1 out of 5 into a 1 out of 5 into a 1 out of 6 into a 1 out of 6. I think that's less than 1%. Like, I should have been able to have, you know, maybe I low roll on a fight or two. But I shouldn't have been down to 2 health there. Like, I also did technically make a mistake. I should have had like 8 health. I don't know, though. It was a hard fought one, but what are you gonna do? We tried to make the claw work. The claw never works. It should have worked, but it didn't. Anyway. Whatever. Maybe my RNG will turn around. My play has to turn around as well, but honestly, the RNG has to as well. So anyway, as always, thanks for watching, and until next time, peace.